trio of crew members who will remain on board the International Space Station, Oleg Novitskiy in the red shirt, Yevgeny Tarelkin in the foreground, and you'll be seeing floating into the field of view the new Expedition 34 commander, Kevin Ford. Expedition 34 begins officially at the time of physical separation of the Soyuz vehicle about 15 minutes from now. The trio lined up at the hatchway in the Rosviet module of the International Space Station as one by one, Hoshide, Williams, and finally Malenchenko said their final farewells, hugs, handshakes, as the trio of departing crew members made their way through the small passageway connecting Rosviet with the Soyuz TMA-05M spacecraft before the hatches were finally closed, the crew members saying goodbye to one another for the final time. On Saturday, it was Williams who handed over command of the International Space Station to Ford, who will remain Expedition 34 commander until mid-March, when Ford, Novitskiy, and Tarelkin come home after 5 months in space. Ford at that time will hand over command of the International Space Station to Canadian Space Agency astronaut Chris Hadfield, who will become the first Canadian to command the International Space Station. Hadfield is scheduled for launch with NASA astronaut Tom Marshburn and Russian cosmonaut Roman Romanenko on December 19th from the Baikonur Cosmodrome.
Агата, МТС, Москва. Yes, this is Агата. We're here. For page 94, work prep, have you performed that? And are you prepared for launching the undocking mode? Yes, we confirm at 01:17:00, we will be ready to send the command.
And you can hear the Russian flight controllers talking as we speak to Yuri Malenchenko, calling him under the call sign of Agat, making sure that everything is ready for the actual command that will be sent at 4:23 p.m. Central Time to initiate the opening of the hooks that have held the Soyuz spacecraft to the Rosviet module since its arrival back on July 17th.